Good morning. Welcome to the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception to celebrate the solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity. On your cellular device, you will find the worship aid for today's Mass on our website, kcgolddome.org. Click on Today. Those using pew hymnals will find the numbers listed on the hymn board. Please silence your devices. Thank you.
We are sorry for our sins, but we rejoice in God's mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd, leading us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
God, our Father, by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, make known to the human race your wondrous mystery. Grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore its unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Exodus. Early in the morning, Moses went up Mount Sinai, as the Lord had commanded him, taking along the two stone tablets. Having come down in a cloud, the Lord stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord. Thus the Lord passed before him and cried out, the Lord, the Lord, a merciful and gracious God, slow to anger and rich in kindness and fidelity. Moses at once bowed down to the ground in worship. Then he said, if I find favor with you, O Lord, do come along in our company. This is indeed a stiff-necked people, yet pardon our wickedness and sins and receive us as your own. The word of the Lord. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice. Mend your ways. Encourage one another. Agree with one another. Live in peace. And the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Oh,
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Ascension, Pentecost, the Trinity, and next week we will celebrate the body and blood of Christ. 4 weeks in a row, we celebrate four of the greatest revelations and mysteries of our faith. Of course, when we talk about mystery, we are not talking about a whodunit, nor are we talking about the little mysteries we encounter in our daily lives. Like, where do those missing socks go to hide? No, we're talking about the deepest mysteries that are at the very core of our faith. Perhaps the best definition of the kind of mystery I'm talking about is that which cannot be explained, yet is infinitely explainable. These are the mysteries that defy the wisdom of the world. God, in his divine wisdom, created man and shared with us some small portion of his divine wisdom, that is, the ability to learn and understand. Then, building upon these gifts of wisdom and understanding, he began to reveal his truths to us, usually in small doses, but occasionally in quantum leaps, like at Mount Sinai, and of course the wealth of divine revelation bestowed by his Son during his brief lifetime on earth. Of course, Jesus' ascension was not the end of revealed truth, because Jesus, as he promised, sent the Holy Spirit to help form, guide, and teach the early church. And the Holy Spirit continues to guide his church, and from time to time, as needed, continues to build on that wealth of revealed truth through the wisdom and teaching authority of his church. But with all this wisdom and understanding, humankind sometimes falls prey to arrogance and finds no room for the God who gave us these gifts. And they think, if we do not know it, or we cannot figure it out, it just must not be so. So much for the doctrine of the feast we celebrate today, the Holy Trinity, the revelation about the very nature of God. The Trinity is certainly a revealed truth, and many theologians have tackled the text of explaining it. Surely we've all heard of St. Patrick's legendary but simplistic shamrock comparison. Some have explained it more successfully than others, but in the end, all explanations have been inadequate, for the Holy Trinity is a mystery which by definition lends itself to infinite explanations and at the same time cannot be explained at all. There's a story, one of my favorites, about St. Augustine walking on a beach contemplating the Trinity. When he saw a small boy with a seashell taking water from the ocean and pouring it into a hole in the sand. When he asked the boy what he was doing, he was told that he was emptying the ocean into the hole. And then, of course, the amused saint told the boy that there was not enough time in all eternity for him to complete such a task. The boy then told St. Augustine that he would, in fact, empty the ocean before the saint would be able to explain the Trinity. The saint learned what we all must accept, that true wisdom and understanding must come humility. With divine revelation, the Spirit often leaves much unexplained until such time God decides we are ready, possibly not until then. So how are we to cope in the meanwhile with such mysteries as the Holy Trinity, that so far unknowable relationship between the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and their loving support for us in our lives? William of Thierry, 12th century French Benedictine abbot, expressed it this way: When in your life of faith, you're confronted with the deeper mysteries, it's natural to become a little frightened. When this happens, take heart, faithful Christian. Do not raise objections, but ask with loving submission, how can these things be? Let your question be a prayer, an expression of love and self-surrender to God. In other words, We must turn to God, love God, trust God and His promises, and until we can grasp the ultimate explanation behind His truth, above all, have faith.
Just inside the front cover of your red hymnal, you'll find the words for the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God. God is merciful and gracious, slow to anger and rich in kindness. Let us bring our petitions to the one who is faithful.
Our response for the Church. May she at all times reflect the wisdom of the Father, the love of the Son, and the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, we pray. For Pope Francis and his June prayer intention that the international community abolish torture and support its victims and their families, and for Bishop Johnson's monthly prayer request for the safety of migrant families, we pray. For all who will be sealed with the Holy Spirit in confirmation here Wednesday evening, that they will become soldiers of Christ in the battle for souls, we pray. For those who struggle with depression, addiction, loneliness, or mental illness, that they will experience the consolation of knowing they are loved by the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we pray. For our Building Glory capital campaign, that demolition and construction be accident-free, and that donations continue so that it may be completed debt-free, we pray. For the sick, especially Knights of Columbus District Deputy John Mahoney, whose district includes the Cathedral Council, may they be consoled by God's grace and the care shown to them by his people. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who have died, especially Humberto Vasquez Gonzalez, the uncle of Adriana Rios, that their purgation be brief and their eternal reward great, we pray. And for the members of the Cathedral Parish for whom this Mass is offered, we pray. Lord.
O God, who gave us your only Son, show the world your love again, and hear our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Sanctify by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in a Trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in the confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance, and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too, and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they acclaim.
So that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Whose death and will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and James, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I pray.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul. As we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Members of our Finance Council are here to greet you after Mass today and give you coffee and donuts to go, or coffee and donuts to linger, whichever you prefer, by the front door. Deacon Steve's study of the Bible timeline continues this Tuesday in person and online. Those interested in joining the Catholic Church meet Thursday. Next Sunday, we welcome Travis Clark into the full communion of the Catholic Church at the 9 o'clock Mass. Young adults are welcome to Catholics and coffee down the street at Spokes next Sunday after this Mass.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.